Hello again. We now come to the topic component creation, which I'm really looking forward to it because it really showcases the strength of my plugins. Why component creation? Most of you maybe have programmed already in Angular, so it might not be a big deal, but I will give a short explanation here. The thing is that if you want to create an application, the pages usually become very big. And to allow reusability and to avoid extreme complexity in your pages, you usually break them up into smaller compositions. Angular has a component system in place, so do many other web frameworks like GSF, which I was heavily involved in a few years ago. And reusability is always good because you don't have to copy yourself. There's always the principle, don't repeat yourself. So how are we going to do that? We here have a view, and we want to make parts of this view reusable. So what are we going to do? We are going to mark this part here. We are going to copy it. And then let's create a view, component, sorry. Here we have the component, create component. And now the first difference to create the view is we have to give a dash case selector name here. It's just like you would define the tag name. Angular 2 enforces this method. Angular 1 wants camel case and then maps it implicitly into dash case. I think it's easier the way Angular 2 handles it, so I implemented that mechanism as well. My first component. Now let's drop the code in here. As you can see here, wonderful syntax coloring. That's the HTML editor we have. And now press OK. The component is generated. And as you can see here, there already is a proposal on what you can use as parameters, as attributes for a tag. It doesn't necessarily have to be the correct way, but the plugins try to pre-pass the code you've given it and try to identify which patterns it can map into attributes. So let's leave it like that. Maybe we are going to rename it to, how are we going to call it? Label, for instance, that's a good one, yeah. Let's rename that one as well. Okay, now we're done with our component. If we go to the module quickly, we see that the component already is entered. There's nothing else to do here. So, back to our view. That would be view one. We are going to replace that part here with a tag. And the label. Controller, then let's give it the name template var 1. Oops, there we go. And now let's go back to our page. View 1, just to make sure that it really is updated. As you can see here, my hello 2. And let's have a look at this element. As you can see here, the component tag is active. Now I want to reuse that one. Let's go to view 2 in this case. Let's use this one here. Ah, sorry, wrong one. Go through. There we have view 2. We're going to drop this one as well. We don't have this instance variable template var 1. We are going to pass straightly a string. Let's call it hello again, save it. Let's go to view 2, and there we are, hello again. And there we are with our component. So the thing now is, we are not limited to components here. We also can generate other artifacts. most of the Angular standard Angular artifacts which you have to use on a daily basis can be generated one way or the other in a very similar way. Quickly have a look at the new here. We can create components for the time being, controllers, the routes. Those are three parts we have covered already. Next part we are going to cover how to create services. And then there's the filters and the directives, which we are probably not going to showcase because they are so similar to creating the components. Yep, that's it for this video. In the next video, I will cover services, REST calls, and DTOs, and the Java 2 TypeScript mapping. So the next one will be a bigger one. Thank you for watching.